If you've ever wanted to buy very cheap rental real estate, you're going to want to take a look at today's show. Rosie and Eddie from California, this video is for you. Let's dive in.
This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world.
Hey, folks, welcome to another episode of the MLS Search and Analysis Show here on Holton Wise TV. As always, I am your host, James Wise. And obviously, for my longtime viewers out there, you can tell I'm not in the Holton Wise TV studio. I'm actually coming to you guys from my home office right now. The story behind that, I just had another child, so congratulations to me and my family. But that's the thing, right? That's actually kind of, you know, what it's all about, right? The fact that I can stay home and still run my business, still earn income, is kind of what you folks are coming to Holton Wise TV for, kind of what you folks are coming to the real estate business for, right? Like today's video, okay? It's for my clients, Rosie and Eddie. You two are investors from California. You guys have invested in properties in California. As I understand it, you bought a bunch of real estate before the latest boom, right? I feel like every 7 years, California is like up and down, right? It's like boom, bust, boom, bust, boom, bust, right? You guys, I think you made a decent chunk of money in the last boom, right? Congratulations. And that's, you know, that's what it's all about. It's what's great about real estate, right? We can do it from anywhere, right? Real estate has allowed me the opportunity to film shows, operate the business while being home with my wife and our children and helping out, right? So that's what it's all about. It's all about helping everybody out there who's interested in making this money do so from wherever they are, right? That's what financial freedom is, right? It's not necessarily like you invest in real estate and you never have to work a day in your life again, right? No, it's not really practical, right? You got to work on your business, right? But it's the freedom to work on your business, you know, where you want, when you want, things like that, right? And Rosie and Eddie, I want to help you guys work on your business, okay? And what you guys have set up for me, right? You guys want to invest in some Cleveland properties, very, very low-cost Cleveland properties, right? You've got $60,000 to work with, and you want a multifamily property. You want to just buy it cash. You're looking at C or D class neighborhoods. So the first thing I want to do is let you know, with that parameter, okay, $60,000 for a multifamily property, that does limit our inventory. We don't have like a ton of stuff under 60K that's going to be multifamily, all right? Now, if you want more inventory, things you can do, right? If you want to also open things up to single family homes, we could definitely have more inventory to choose from under the 60K price point. In addition to that, if you want to go to like F-class neighborhoods, we can find you some stuff, but I don't necessarily know that's the right move. So if you're looking for more inventory, I would say we open it up to single family homes as well, or we want to increase that budget a little bit, maybe bring that up to 80 to 100K, right? If you're trying to get multifamily in C-class neighborhoods, you definitely need to be around 100K as your total budget. But all that said, I still found you a multifamily property. It was under 60K and is in a D-class neighborhood. So it can be done. I've done it for you today, but you know, you have multiple videos coming for me. So if you guys want them in like a rapid fashion, you'll need to open up that criteria for me. Or if you don't, you just want to stick to this criteria, that's great. We can do that. But just know that it's not necessarily like I can get you a video and then I can get you a video next week and then the week after, right? Like when I find a property for you, I could turn the video on about 24 hours, but it's all about having the properties available. So like, you know, it might be like 3 weeks in between videos, might be 2 months in between videos, right? I can't sell you what doesn't exist. But for starters, we got one to work with and then we'll go from there. So this property, 3345 West 63rd, Cleveland, 44102, just hit the market 4 days ago, folks. $58,900, right? Now, this is pretty much the only duplex that I saw that would fit what you guys are trying to do. And I do like it, but there's a little bit of limited information, right? All the listing agent has given us is the one picture of the front yard. Now, This is a D-class property. However, it's in an area of west side of Cleveland where it's very close to MetroHealth. It's a major medical provider here that is investing $1 billion into the Cleveland market. So I really like this area. I love it. As a matter of fact, we are investing a ton of money into it. And, you know, it's going to come with risks, but what I like to do is alleviate those risks and operate these properties on the Section 8 program.
Are you a lender? If so, Holton Wise is looking to partner with you. If you're licensed in all 50 states, go to holtonwise.com. Click the digital media tab to advertise on Holton Wise TV today.
Right, the biggest risk with low-income neighborhoods is the tenants don't pay rent. Then you got to evict them. Then after you evict them, the property goes vacant. And then, you know, other assholes come in, break in, fuck your house up, right? Those are the big costs, the big downfalls. So you can alleviate a lot of those problems with the Section 8 program. Currently, this property is fully occupied, right? I know you guys didn't want to do any big renos, right? We have two tenants in there paying $600 apiece. So that's $1,200 a month coming in, $14,400 a year coming in. They are not currently on the Section 8 program, but that doesn't mean going forward in the future, we won't operate new tenants coming in on the Section 8 program, right? When you do buy occupied rental properties, you know, that is a risk you take, right? You get the tenants that the old guy put in there, right? You know, it's kind of an unknown, right? They haven't been screened by Holton Wise. You just kind of got to roll the dice on it. But there's not a lot of inventory out there under this price point. So you got to understand how cheap the property you're actually buying is, right? $58,900. Now, back to this one photo, right? We don't have much information on this property. Now, as far as like the interior of these units go, it's not really going to matter, okay? Because here's the deal, guys. You're investing in a D-class neighborhood. When eventually these tenants move out, you're going to be doing a unit turnover, dude. You ain't setting it up where like, first of all, just look at the picture. Like you got plywood and stuff like on the bottom under the porch instead of the lattice. You got like cracking. You up top there, you got like green with some other random color green. So just based upon what I'm looking at here, I don't want you guys thinking that this is like some super, like everything in this property is brand new. We've got no information on the roof, the furnaces, and the hot water tanks, okay? I'm going to tell you right now, no scenario where the roof, the furnaces, and the hot water tanks are all brand new. So don't think that they're new. What's going to happen? We're going to send in our home inspector if we go under contract on this property. And he's going to tell us that all of these items are mid to end of life or past their useful life expectancy. What that means, right? Furnaces, they last 30 years on average. Hot water tanks, they last 15 years on average. Roofs, on average, last 30 years. Roof on a house like this is probably like a $6,000, $7,000 roof. Furnaces, they're about $3,000 to replace. Hot water tanks, they're about $1,000 to replace. We are going to rock all of these until we have issues. The day the roof starts leaking, boom, we're going to set it up to replace the roof. The day a furnace goes down, instead of a service call to fix it, we're going to replace the furnace. Day a hot water tank goes down, we replace it, okay? That's what the plan is, but that's all baked into the cake, right? So because of all that, the agent listed it pretty damn low, 58.9. And what I think, since you guys are cash buyers, I think we can come in and maybe try to pick it up at 50,000, okay? If we pick this thing up at 50,000, it's bringing in 14,400 a year. Of that, based upon average annual expenses, I think you guys will profit 7,320. Now, there's some things in here that are variable, right? Let's take a look at the capital expenditures. I'm calculating $720 a year in capital expenditures. That doesn't mean you're actually spending $720. What that means is you're saving $720. So like you're getting rental disbursements from us, but of those $720 every year, you're putting in a special bank account or your pocket knowing that eventually you're going to get a $3,000 furnace bill, a $7,000 roof bill, a $1,000 hot water tank bill, right? You know that every 15 to 30 years, those costs are going to incur, right? So you're saving up for those, right? So I didn't even, like that extra money that's coming in, we're not counting that as your actual return, right? That is not counted in your 7,320 of net profit, right? That's on top of that because you know those costs are eventually going to come up, okay? So keep that in mind. Additionally, right, I'm also factoring in 720 for your repairs and your maintenance. Unlikely we're doing a lot of monthly repairs, but like I said, dudes, you're gonna need to do a turnover when D-class tenants move out. Like, you don't just get to vacuum it and throw a new tenant in there, right? You're gonna be repainting stuff, patching holes, right? Fixing it up, right? That's why the interior photos are not that important, right? The current tenants, they're cool with it, great. No scenario where a new tenant is gonna move into it without us doing a refresh after these current tenants are gone, right? So it's irrelevant at the moment because we know we're gonna, you know, spend money turning it over. So we're factoring that in. And lastly, too, the vacancy and non-payment, right? Biggest issue with D-class investing is tenants don't pay rent. You got a victim, then you got a vacant unit, things of that nature, right? We're gonna calculate that in because we know it's always going to happen, right? You're never going to set it up where, like, we put a tenant in there and you collect 100% of the rent. That is not how this business works. That's always going to be something that's happening, right? If you have, like, a large portfolio of properties, you're always going to have somebody not paying, right? We're going to alleviate that risk as much as we possibly can, mitigate the risk as much as possible by going with the Section 8 program, but know that that stuff is still going to happen, right? So all that's been factored in, all that's been built into the cake, right? Baked into the cake. So, with all that said, if you guys pick this thing up at 50 G's, I think it's a 14.6 cap. Now, you guys said you want to pay cash. Great. But just so you know, we have lenders for you if you wanted to finance this, right? So we do have lenders that can write you loans, 30-year loans, fixed interest loans, low interest runs. If they did that, you guys would only need to put up $12,500. They'd loan you the other 37.5, which would make this probably an average annual return of over 40%, right? 43.4%. But if you just want to buy it cash, that's totally cool too. We can do it either way. I think this would be a pretty solid investment. This is stage one of the due diligence, right? The next step, if you guys are interested, just reply to this private email. And what we will do, if you guys want to move forward, we'll put in the bid. $50,000 is where I'd like to start things off. I'd like to take it down there. And we'll make that offer contingent on your own third-party home inspection, right? If we get it under contract, maybe it's like at 50, maybe it's a little bit higher, you know, somewhere around that area. Then we'll send the inspector in there. They'll check everything out. So long as he doesn't come back with any like major structural issues, like, I don't know, like foundation issues or, you know, just super big things, right? If he's just saying like, you know, some stuff is old, some stuff is worn out, and the mechanicals I just talked about are older, you know, that's all baked into the cake. I think that's great, but we want to make sure we're not getting some crazy unknowns. Like if there's a major foundation issue with this property that blows the deal, we got to exit the deal. But other little ticky-tack items, you know, they're to be expected based upon the price point and the condition of the property from the one photo we've been given, right? As far as not being given other photos, I just want to clarify for you guys and all those new investors out there that are watching. I don't want you guys to think that that's like a major red flag, right? Like, here's the deal, y'all. It's fucking hard to deal with tenants, right? You're dealing with like low income tenants. It's a bitch, right? To get into the properties and check everything out. On top of that, you add in the COVID thing right now. Like, who wants a bunch of random people coming in their house, right? So don't think that that is a major red flag. It's pretty par for the course. As a matter of fact, when we sell property here on Holton Wise TV, our other show, the Investment Properties for Sales show, we only sell our properties via that show. We do a one video tour, and then we never let anybody into the property other than at a third-party home inspection, right? A lot of realtors that don't work with investors, don't work with rentals, they try to sell these the same way they sell regular properties, where they try to schedule showings. Like, buyers are like, oh, I want to buy this property, and like, we bother the tenants to let them in. That stuff doesn't work. It doesn't make sense. It's inefficient, especially during the day and age of COVID, right? So you guys have to understand, you have to be logical here. It's pretty par for the course. The tenants are going to make your life difficult if people are trying to get into their home, you know, during a freaking pandemic or just in general, right? That coupled with the fact that dudes, I mean, we've had thousands and thousands of tenants. We run the biggest portfolio in the city. It doesn't really even, it's not that big of a deal to see like what color the walls are painted or what the kitchen looks like. Cause I'm telling you, when they move out, we're going to be doing a refresh anyway. We're going to be repainting everything. If there's carpet, it's getting removed. We're going to buff those hardwood floors, put a nice epoxy coating. So like if, you know, stuff gets spilled on it or people pee on it or pets pee on it, it doesn't like get soaked into the wood and smell like urine. We're going to be doing those things to harden those units. So just know that you're going to spend some money whenever these two tenants do turn over. Do they turn over 6 months from now, 5 years from now? I can't exactly tell you. Again, these tenants are going to be unknown. But these are all the risks you have to take when you're trying to buy an incredibly cheap property like this, because a duplex for under $60,000, guys, is beyond cheap in the Cleveland market of D-class or higher neighborhoods, right? So that is everything. Also, if this deal doesn't work for you, like I said, we could either stick with these very tight parameters and it's going to take some while in between videos, or if you want to open things up, we could increase the budget, or we can open it up to single family homes. Just give us the feedback. Just reply to the link. Let us know what you want to do. Everybody else out there, if you watch today's show and you're like, hey man, I want to invest in really cheap real estate. I want to invest out of state. Maybe I live in California as well and it's very expensive. I like what you guys are doing. First thing you want to do to work with us is go to holtonwise.com, click the property search for sale tab, click the MLS search analysis show. Order yourself a package and I can do videos like this for you. It's part coaching, part buyer representation. And then after you guys close, my team, we handle all the property management, all the maintenance. We even handle insurance. So anybody out there who's got rental properties, and don't even have to just be in Cleveland, guys. We are licensed to do insurance coast to coast, right? So if you guys have rental properties and you guys want us to try to lower your premiums, click the show notes below. We could probably help you out with that, because that's all we do. We don't do anything other than rentals. So we find we typically are able to take most investors' premiums and get them lowered, right? Put a little more of that ROI in your pocket, right? But yeah, so if you want to buy these properties in Cleveland, though, guys, we are the one-stop shop. We will do it all for you. Starts here with the education, give you an idea of what you're buying. Maybe what you see in the first video you don't like. That's why we do multiple videos, right? You give me feedback, and we go from there. And, you know, maybe for Eddie and Rosie, we do this deal. Maybe we don't. And my team, we go back, we hit the drawing board, and I give you guys something different on the next one, right? That's what we do. If you guys are interested, check it out. That's pretty much all I've got for the day. I probably got some poopy diapers I need to go help my wife change right now. So I'm going to get out of here, folks. I'd like you guys to go to Holton Wise TV on YouTube and smash that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. That's it, folks. As always, I'm James Wise with Holton Wise, and this is Real Estate Investing Made Easy.
This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world.
US REIB is a full-service, turnkey provider offering investors the opportunity to purchase single-family and multifamily investment properties in Cincinnati, Ohio, Dayton, Ohio, and Kansas City, Missouri. The purchase process is seamless, from reserving a property to obtaining financing, inspections, and insurance referrals. US REIB has a dedicated team in place to manage the process from start to finish. In addition, US REIB is also directly integrated with its own private placement fund for accredited investors. The fund seeks to raise $10 million to capitalize on the repositioning of distressed single-family and multifamily real estate.
RentTech Direct provides you with an easy-to-use yet robust platform for managing your properties, complete with its built-in reporting and accounting system that can be customized to fit your business. For property managers, you get advanced features like simplified owner distributions, automated management and placement fees, an owner portal, plus the software is certified for trust accounting. All this comes backed by the highest rated customer support team in the industry, certified by third parties and ranked number one by our clients year over year. You get unlimited free access to our US-based support team by phone, email, and chat, who will help you getting started or anywhere along the way.
G'day everyone, it's Angelo Remora here, your favorite Australian and the founder and owner of Ohio Cashflow. Over the last 5 years, Ohio Cashflow has established itself as the most reputable turnkey real estate investment company in the country. We offer solid B-class properties in Toledo, Ohio. We work and live in the same areas that we sell in. So when we sell your property, your tenants become our neighbors. We only take on a handful of investors every month. So for your chance to work with one of the best in the business, please fill out our investor application form, which you can find in the video notes below. Thanks for listening. And as we say down under, I'll catch you later, mate. Is that it?
Yeah, we're done.
All right, cool.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on our latest content, including video tours and analysis of investment properties that are available for sale, real estate investment education, and our most interesting encounters with tenants from hell. Fulton Wise, real estate investing made easy.